What's up, guys? It's Caveman Mining. I hope everyone is well and having a great day. As discussed in our previous preview, we are going to be testing the new T-Rex Miner 0.24.0 on the 3060 Light Hash Revision 2 card. And we're going to do Ethereum and Ergo specifically today to see what we get for hash rates, efficiency, and if we can truly get that 100% full hash rate lock. So we will see you guys in just a second within the computer into Windows. Okay, guys, we are back here, and now we are in Windows, and we've got the test rig fired up. We've already have the batch file for Ethereum and Ergo running, and you can see here we've got 13.07 and 74.43 going, so we'll let that keep spooling up there. Just want to show you quickly, we'll get the batch file up to review. Just at a high level, I want to show you that Ergo in ETH for T-Rex Miner 0.24.0, you need to have 8 gigabytes of RAM minimally, and here it's going to show you the 3080 Ti through the 3060 in terms of what to set or what to have for targets for Ethereum hash rate and Ergo hash rate, your power limits, and your overclock settings. Now, you do need to plug these into your batch file slash notepad file at the end, and we'll go over that to have your core clocks and your memory clocks set there. And then the same with Raven. One thing to note with Raven is you need to have 10 gigs of RAM on a card for Windows to get your achievable hash rates, and you can have as low as 8 gigs of RAM on Linux. So just to note that in Ethereum and Conflux there, you need 10 gigs of RAM regardless of operating system and their targets. And then just at a very quick high level, the option two, if you don't want to dual mine, they have refined the 70% hash rate for one single coin, which is really merely for Ethereum on this, targeted for Ethereum. So that's something to keep in mind here. If we look here at our notepad slash batch file, we have the path for T-Rex Miner connected up there, as well as our algorithm arguments and our wallets and servers for Ethereum and AutoLycos for Ergo. And then you'll see at the end, this is more important for, I mentioned the overclocking arguments. I have a fan argument in there with a target of 55. I have the core clock set to zero, the lock core clock at 1240, and the memory clock at 1300. So I found my particular card with the core clock locked at 1250, I was having some issues with that, with the card was locking pretty fast here, and this seems to be okay-ish. It's doing some funky things with AutoLycos, and obviously we get to let this run for quite some time. That's kind of a thing I would suggest for the sake of this video. This is just going to be a quick pass, but you'll probably see in the beginning when you run the miner, you're going to have some varying hash rates, and then at some point it's going to get its sweet spot and really tune in there. But yeah, we had a hash rate earlier of 74 mega hash on AutoLycos, and now we've got 72. Sorry, as I'm scrolling like crazy here. Yeah, 14 mega hash on Ethereum, and we had up to 74 on AutoLycos. So just want to look at a quick profitability standpoint here, right? So we just did 14 on ETH hash, we'll leave the wattage zero because we'll plug it in down here. And then we said 74 on auto Lycos at, we'll take a walk over now because I just want to show you guys what we're pulling at the wall live. And we'll go over to our wattage meter. And it looks like we are in the realm of 165 to 167 watts seems to be the kind of area of variation on the wattage, which I have to say, compared to the earlier versions of T-Rex Miner and NB Miner and some of the other miners that have the light hash rate refinements, that is definitely much better or consistent wattage. So I'm pretty happy with that. That is a good thing to see. So yeah, you can see we jumped up to 14.71 and back up to 70, almost 71 mega hash on auto Lyco. So obviously we'll let this run for quite some time, but I think the numbers that I have up here, you know, pretty accurate in terms of achievability with what we have. And let's just run some quick numbers here. I'm gonna take out Raven Coin on there because I've previously had that cashed in. So do a little bit of math, do 82 cents plus 99 cents, 82, actually go 0.82 plus 0.99, $1.81 would be our profitability if we were to run this on the 3060. Now, let's just look at, I think we can achieve or get pretty close to 40 mega hash now with some of these miners running straight Ethereum, and we get probably about 130 watts there. Let's calculate that. $2.41, right? So that's that's a no-brainer, right? That's a no-brainer in terms of profitability and mining Ethereum over running this dual miner. And then auto Lycos, I think we were able to get like 116.50 at 140 watts, I want to say, roughly was one of our tests that we ran in the past. So yeah, after the cost of electricity, $1.48. So you know, the dual miner is still more profitable than just mining straight ergo, but Ethereum is kind of leading the race on this card. Now, I've seen other videos. I know Red Fox Mining did a video comparing the hash rates. I know Chump Change XD also did one with his 3070 card. And I think if you might have a 3080 Ti or a 3070 or a higher card than a 3060, it might be beneficial to run the miner, the dual miner. But for this particular 3060 light hash revision 2, just to be clear, it's a revision 2 card, it is not more profitable than running or mining straight Ethereum at the moment, or even Ravencoin for that matter. I think, you know, Raven, if we were just to go back, run a quick test on Ravencoin, I think we were able to get 25 mega hash at, was it 140 watts on Kapow. We'll take a look at that. And yeah, $2.22. So still more profitable to mine Ravencoin straight up, and still more profitable to mine Ethereum for this particular card. I just have to reiterate that over and over again. Still better than the dual miner, but time will tell. Time will tell. Let's see if another version comes out. And we know HiveOS is eagerly working on an update to get the 0.24.0 T-Rex Miner in one of their newer versions. So I'll be kind of eagerly waiting to test that out and see if there's any variability or variance in terms of hash rate or efficiency versus running in Windows. So maybe we'll catch that on another video. And I know I'm pretty limited on time and I want to keep this video up to the point. I will consider doing a Ravencoin and Ethereum test potentially in the next video, just to see what we get. I know obviously on Linux, on Linux, we're able to get a little bit better stats there versus Windows. So we'll see what that does in the next, potentially the next video. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna cut this video here at this point. Well, I'm gonna really let this miner run. I would like to let it run overnight and see where things kind of pan out for the long haul of shares and uptime, and if we get any big jumps in terms of hash rate, which you can see there that we went up to was over 15 mega hash, almost 16 mega hash on Ethereum, and just staying around the 71, 72 mark, or 70 to 72 mark of auto LICO. So I'm gonna cut the video here, guys, because my camera is starting to overheat. I'm gonna lose the footage, but yeah, hopefully you learned something. Please leave in the comments if you have mined using this T-Rex dual miner. Let me know your overclocks. Let me know if you have done this on a 3060. And with that said, guys, we will see you on the next video. Please feel free to like and subscribe, and we will see you next time. Take care.